Hello, very warm welcome to Dr. Zia Ahmed YouTube channel. Today in this short video also, we are going to talk about a very famous character which appears in the drama Waiting for Godot, that is written by Samuel Beckette. So this character is going to be Godot. There has been number of issues, number of discussions, number of points of views of the people in order to locate and find out who is Godot and what is the kind of role he is going to play in the drama. A lot of discussion has taken place, and while I was teaching to my class, many interesting views came up. So I decided to record a video on these views of my students and as well as mine own, or what the view emerges out of the studies of this drama. So as everybody knows that Waiting for Godot is an absurd play divided into two acts. And there a number of characters appear. It is definitely the basic characters are Estragon and Vladimir, and then the two more characters add them in the middle of the first act, that is Lucky and Puzzle. And the second act also the same thing happens, that two characters, Estragon and Vladimir, come and talk or discuss their things. Similarly, Lucky and Puzzle once again interpret the role of Puzzle, and Lucky is reversed. Meanwhile, just a boy is there who appears, is a nameless boy, there's no name to given to him. That boy appears in the end of the first act also, saying that Godot has not come today, and possibly he may be coming today or next day. And so the people wait for the second day also, and again he comes and says, unfortunately, Godot is not coming. So who is this Godot? Why so much fuss about him when lots of other things are going on about these characters in the drama? In order to understand this whole thing, we need to talk about, first of all, what does the dramatist actually meant? This is an absurd play, everybody knows this is an absurd play, and in the absurd plays, there is the nothingness most of the time, the uselessness of the things, and the life which is here, dissatisfaction with the life of the characters and the people, all these things are discussed in detail. This drama, absurd drama, is very much different from the traditional dramas of Shakespeare and Marlowe. So one can also see that the absurd drama not only talks about this nothingness of and the emptiness of man's life, modern man's life especially, it also goes to talk about the existentialist philosophy, how the human beings are existing and what the purpose of their life is going to be, and are they satisfied with their life or they are 100% dissatisfied. With reference to that, this drama has been written. So while deciding or thinking about who is Godot, one has to keep these things in mind. Interestingly enough, the title of the drama is Waiting for Godot. They're all the people, all the characters. We cannot say that. It is just two characters, Estragon and Vladimir. These are waiting for the Godot. Why brings information while the other two characters, Lucky and Pozo, do not even talk about that? So therefore, Godot is the demand of these two characters, who are the tramps, who are the people who don't have the houses, who are the people who on the road, who are the people they are suffering, who are the people who need the help and the support, who have almost lost their hope because of the life presented to them. And so they want him to come, and probably they want him to come to solve the issues which they are suffering from. So once the dramatist Samuel Beckette was asked that, who is Godot, can you tell us? And interestingly enough, he replied that if he had known that, definitely he would have written the drama. So the dramatist concealed the purpose of including this name Godot in the drama so that they should be 100% interested in that. Just as in Shakespearean drama Hamlet, if Hamlet had killed his opponents in the very beginning and got the control and married Ophelia, where would the drama be? If today Hamlet is the classical drama, is the drama number one of the world, it's only because Hamlet didn't kill the people in the beginning. Same is the case with this Godot. If this Godot had appeared, if this Godot had come, then where would the drama? So drama is about the coming, appearing, and talking and discussing and fulfilling the role of that divine being, which possibly is that Godot is there inside the drama. There are certain interpretations that the people have tried to give. Like it's a very, a very strange type of interpretation that in French, the word Godot means the used or useless boot of a person. Now this interpretation cannot be there because it's the mood which Estragon has, and Vladimir helps him remove it, ultimately they wear it as well. Moods are there, sometimes they lose it, sometimes they gain it once again. So why they should be waiting for the boot? So it is not going to be the boot. The symbolic interpretations may be taken into one way, but boot is not, according to my opinion, the interpretation of Godot. There is the religious interpretation taken from Irish people. Irish people give the divine interpretation to this word, and so possibilities that there is more of the expectation from the divine people that Godot is meant to be. So similarly, when we read the drama in the context of postmodernism, in the context of the modern century, modern ages, we also come to know that possibly Godot is the god. The god who possibly is the capitalist god who can come and remove the problem of the people, or because of his non-existence or non-cooperation the problem is going to be there. There could be some interpretation of politics as well, that he is the one who is not coming to solve the problem of the poor. Democracy, for example, is believed to be the thing which can solve the problem of the middle class and the poor class. But if it does not, then definitely it's like Godot and doesn't come to do the things which is supposed to be. So the systems in the Western countries, in the northern part of the world, though termed as the democratic systems, they have not come up to solve the problem of the poor man. And so poor man is still waiting for a solver, for a kind of person who comes and helps him. So in this way, the only interpretation that we can have is the interpretation, religious interpretation, that we can accord to Godot. So Godot is a god. Godot is a type of Christ who should come to help the suffering humanity. It is well known, according to the Christian theology, according to Christian philosophy of religion, that man is not happy in this world. He has come to suffer. And even Christ himself was a sufferer. He also waited that man his suffering should end. Same is the case with the common, normal human beings, that they too are here in this world, are suffering, are having problems, and their problems cannot be solved by any ordinary person. These problems can be solved with the help of a divine being. So Godot is possibly a divine being from whom everybody, you know, needs to get help in order to solve these issues. And possibly this is the disappointment of humanity, that all their efforts, all their systems, innovations have failed to alleviate the problems of the poor, and so now the poor are returning back towards God, towards their faith, towards some divine being to help them. So most probable interpretation of Godot is the god, but not in the sense that it should be the god of the Muslims or the Christians or whatever. It's a kind of divine interpretation which is a type of expectation. And by the way, the word expectation reminds me that when we are in trouble, we do have a hope, we do have an expectation that one day or sometime it will happen, some miracle will take place, somebody would come to solve our problem, and most probably it's the divine being which can solve. When the problems in the hands of the human beings are unsolvable, they lack the power to do so, it is the faith which helps and heals the injuries and helps the miserable people. So that is why it is the name of the expectation, it's the name of the hope. You know, in the drama, people continue to wait in the first act in the hope that Godot is going to come to solve the problem. This hope is revived at the end, that do not lose the hope, do not become disappointed, because next day the possibility is that Godot will be coming. And same happens in the second day. So these characters pass their one day in the hope of the solution of their problems to some divine being. They pass the second day as well. So in this way, the passage of the time continues to go on. Godot may come or may not come. It is the hope, it is the expectation of the poor man that somehow they may be relieved of the problems which they are suffering from. The problems of the modern man are because of capitalism, are because of the inequality of distribution of wealth, or because of the internal and external suffering of the modern man. He has become hollow, he has become empty. The postmodern age has even pushed the further limits, and the 21st century has made it easier for the people who have the money, and it has made it difficult for the people who don't have the money. But these people are not losing their courage still, because they think that God is there, Godot is there, that some divine being is there who would come. So that is the hope which is sustaining their lives, and they are getting hold on to this hope as well. Now, what does the drama teach? The drama teaches that We need to solve our problem ourselves. Nobody else is coming. No one is coming from outside, from anywhere. No one is coming. Yes, we can seek the divine hope, but we cannot put all our things on the divine being that it will come and solve us. Though, yes, I know that we are disappointed. We have this type of problem, but still, it is us people. After the creation of this world, it is us people who have solved our problem. And this is solvable. It's not the impossibility. However, humanity needs to learn a lot. And this is the hope of everyone in the modern age, that ultimately divine intervention may be or may not be there, but the human beings will learn a lesson that they have to solve their problem by cooperation, by coordination, by tolerance, by friendship, and by living, not only living, but also letting the other people live. So thank you very much for watching. I hope the concept about Godot is clear, up to some extent, not totally, of course, I cannot do that, but up to some extent it is clear, and the students can take help of this video in preparing their assignment, which may be titled as Who is Godot in that drama. So thank you for watching. Hope to see you in some next video in the same way. If you like it, do not fail to hit the subscribe button and to hit the like button and give your comments also, because I usually read these comments and try to include in my recordings next time. So thank you. See you again.